Hi folks, Melvin here from OptoProductions.com, and in this video I'm gonna continue my Waldorf Blofeld series. So in this video we're gonna take a look at the filter section. Right, so the Blofeld has two filters, which really adds a lot of sound shaping possibilities to a synth. I've initialized the sound again, and I'm using a pulse wave on oscillator 1. The balance is set to filter 1 only, but let's change that to the middle. So now it goes to both filters in parallel. Filter 1 is already set to a low pass filter. But let's change filter 2 to a high pass filter. So right here we can change the type with encoder number 3. Now if I play around with the resonance and cutoff, you can hear that both filters are summed together. Now what if I want to change the filter routing to a serial setup? Then we need to go to the routing menu, and this menu is in between filter 1 and filter 2. So if we select filter 2 and move back one step, you can see the routing is set to parallel, but we can change this to serial. And as you can see on the screen, the output of filter 1 is connected straight to filter 2. And this allows us to filter out unnecessary low end, like you can do on the Roland Juno 60. Or it can be fun to add extreme resonances to the high pass filter in order to add a low end bump, as you can do on the Korg MS-20. I might need to turn down the volume. And this might work better if we swap the order of the filters. So we choose a high pass filter for filter 1, and for filter 2 we'll select a low pass filter. Let's scroll through some of the menus. Okay, so on page 1 we've got a key tracking option. So if you increase this number, the higher I play on my keyboard, the more the filter will open up. Which usually sounds more natural. Or you can reverse it, of course. If you play higher, the filter closes. And we can also change the velocity sensitivity. So the louder I play, the brighter the sound. Next, we can change the modulation source. So LFO 1 by default. And we don't need to select the filter envelope here, because this is controlled by the rightmost encoder, which is already tied to the filter envelope. But we can also use another source, like LFO 2, 3, or the amplifier envelope. But more about the modulation options later on. On page 3 we've got the FM options, so we can modulate the frequency of the filter cutoff. So let's choose oscillator 2, and if we change the oscillator to a sine wave and turn down the octave, if we want we can lower the level all the way. And if we switch back to the filter, you can see that it remembers the page number we were on, so that's useful. But if I now turn up the FM amount, that's pretty cool already. But on oscillator 2, we can now disable the key tracking. And we can even detune this oscillator. Next, the fun stuff, distortion. So right here we've got a drive control, which also adds a ton of volume. So make sure you have plenty of headroom on your mixer or interface, which I don't right now. So I'll just turn down the level. And with the control on the right, we can select a bunch of different distortion types. From subtle, to total annihilation. Just remember to play another note when you change these settings, otherwise you won't hear any change. Right on the next page, we can pan the filter output. And one page further, we can add a pan modulation source, which is set to LFO1 by default. So this is a cool trick to add more movement to your sounds, especially when you use different filters in parallel mode. Right, so we can change the filter type right here. So we've got the usual stuff, a low-pass filter, band-pass filter, a high-pass filter, a notch filter. Here we've got something unique, and that is a comb filter. A comb filter is made by adding a very short delay to the sound, and a cutoff knob controls the delay time. So similar to how a phaser or a flanger effect works. And the resonance control changes the height of each resonant peak. So this is especially cool if we modulate this with an LFO. So mod source LFO 1. That sounds amazing. Oh yeah, and by the way, we've got two comb filters, so a plus and a minus, which are basically phase shifted. Alright, finally we've got a Waldorf PPG filter emulation. And this one has a typical sound when you crank up the resonance. So if we compare this to the regular low-pass filter, so another color to play around with. Alright, so I hope this video gave you a good overview of the filter section. In the next video, we're gonna take a look at the modulation section. So if you have any questions in the meantime, just let me know in the comments. And I'll see you in part 3.